When you are presented with one pure tone, you hear one pure tone. You might expect that if you were presented with two pure tones simultaneously, you would hear just two tones. Surprisingly, this is not always so. If the two tones are in the mid-frequency range and are close enough together, you may hear a third sound. For example, here is a soprano singing a note. Now another soprano will sing a note an interval of a fifth higher. Now both together. Notice the barely audible note that is pitched lower than either of the notes sung. Listen again. You have just heard what are called subjective tones. When two tones are present in the air at the same time, they may interfere with each other, sometimes reinforcing, sometimes partially canceling. The intensity of the combined sounds rises and falls at a rate which is the difference between the frequencies of the two sounds. Your hearing mechanism interprets this rising and falling intensity as a third sound, a subjective tone. Here is another example, a London police whistle. The whistle is made of two short pipes. If we blow only one of them, the whistle emits a high pitch tone with a frequency of 2136 cycles per second. If we blow the other pipe, the whistle emits another high pitch tone of different frequency, 1904 cycles per second. If we blow them together, you may become aware of a lower pitch in addition to the two original tones. This lower pitch corresponds to the difference in frequency between the two original tones, 232 cycles per second. Thus, the tone is called a difference tone. Under certain circumstances, this difference tone provides a useful function. Listen as we sound on a trombone, a note having a fundamental frequency of 220 cycles per second. As we know, not only the fundamental, but a complement of overtones are heard having frequencies of 440, 660, 880, 1100, and so forth. The difference in frequency between any two adjacent overtones is 220, which is the frequency of the fundamental component. Now, by means of a filter, we will cut out the fundamental component from the sound. Did you notice that although there was a slight change in quality, there was no difference in pitch between the full tone and the filtered tone? Listen again. First, the full tone. Now the tone with the fundamental filtered out. The pitch is the same. Now what happened? The difference tone supplied by one or more pairs of the overtones produced the sensation of 220 cycle pitch, even though the 220 cycle component of the sound was omitted. Now we will eliminate the fundamental and the first two overtones. Notice that the pitch still corresponds to that of the non-existent fundamental. The same phenomenon can be observed in speech. First, listen to this voiced sound. Ah. Now we will repeat the sound with the fundamental component filtered out. Ah. Notice that although there is a slight difference in quality, the pitch remained the same. As before, the sensation of pitch was produced by the difference between the overtones of the voice. Listen again. Ah. 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 Now we'll try filtering out the fundamental and the first two overtones. Ah. Notice the pitch is the same. Listen again. First the full sound, then without the fundamental and the first two overtones. This phenomenon is relied on for the manufacture of ordinary radio loudspeakers. These loudspeakers are generally small, and they have a poor response in the low frequency range. The radio engineer relies on this subjective effect to give you the sensation of correct pitch.